Thanks for giving me all the birthday wishes so far. Two birthdays on Saturday. I'll be in Boston for PAX East, taking a look at some new games and live streaming from there as well. So make sure you subscribe and turn on the notification bell. We'll be live here on YouTube with that one. And should be a good time. Let's jump back in the Supermarket Simulator. Wow, this is some serious... That's some serious music. Let's do that, and then let's try something like this. There we go. Let's do that. We'll do some original Sims music while we play. Welcome back to the supermarket. All right, so the recent big update now allows us to hire these stockers who will then go to the room and restock shelves for us, which is really cool. And not only that, but they'll do the refrigerators and the freezers and things like that. And we had a huge problem with debt, but now we're finally out of it. We like took out a $5,000 loan, bought a bunch of stuff. We had to grind it out because we bought a ton of space for the grocery store. We bought a ton of shelves, bought a ton of freezers, bought a ton of space for the storage room, hired some new employees, bought a ton of stuff to put on those shelves. And then, yeah. But we're nowhere near done. We got a lot to do, so let's get rocking. We got 905 bucks. Let's check out our store a little bit. What we might need. Could buy a box of everything just to get some shelves stocked up. Let's buy some, maybe some cereal, some tea, pasta, milk, that kind of stuff. Yo, Milo, thank you very much for the Twitch Prime sub for 4 months. Thank you very much. You started playing this last night. I absolutely love it. Oh, good. Good to hear. Good to hear. Yeah, it's been a lot of fun to play this one for sure. Let's do coffee, and let's do tea, let's do milk, maybe one of those milks too. Oh, we're at max. Oh, we had stuff ordered from last time. Oh, okay. Oh, we'll place that order then, and then we'll redo our order. So milk, coffee, tea, what else did I say? Cereal? That's four. I'm going to start letting the boys get to work by just popping these on the shelves. They'll go stock them right away. Get to work, boys! Time to get it done. I'm just going to throw whatever on these shelves just to have them start stocking. Bum, 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 bum. Did I remember to grab my Steam Spring Stream... spring sale. Oh, the Steam spring sale stuff. Yeah. You guys were telling me about that. You know what's weird? Like, last night I got an email about the springs, like the Steam spring sale, but it only ends on the, like, it was only 4 days. I thought those things usually went like 2 weeks or so. I don't know. I'm sorry. I was very confused. Even reading that, I was like, yeah, yeah. Because I only got a notification about it like halfway through the sale, so. But anyway, yeah, I got one or two things that are on my wish list that I still need to buy. I really wish there was like multiple tiers to your wish list, because I feel like there's some things I add to my wish list just to like know when they come out, right? Like just to get the thing that says an item from your wish list is now on sale or whatever, like it's now available. And then there's things where you want it to go on sale, where like maybe it's a game that came out a while ago and you're just waiting for the perfect time to buy it. I feel like I want to give them different markers. Like there should be like, you know, like when you go to Cold Stone Creamery and there's like the like it, love it, gotta have it. I feel like that should be a thing on Steam where it's like some games you just want to keep an eye on and see how it turns out. Maybe they're early access. You want to see how the game's development goes before you buy it. Maybe it's a game you want to get when it only goes on like a super, super sale. And then maybe you just, you know, want to know the day that it comes out. I don't know. I wish there was different tiers because I've got... The reason sometimes I have trouble buying stuff on the sale is because I've got about like 200 things on my wish list, but they're not all ones that I want to buy. Or at least buy immediately. Like some I just want to keep an eye on and see like what's going on with its development. So whatever. Okay, let's do soap. Dire Spitfire, thank you very much for your tier one sub as well. Oh boy, we have ourselves a hype train on Twitch. Exclamation point Twitch in the YouTube chat. You become a Twitch sub if you'd like to. Drop your Twitch sub off over there and keep the train a-rolling. All right, we need hand soap desperately. What else do we need? Ooh, things are looking real stocked though. Like, not bad. Like, we're not empty. Maybe some more cheese. Cheese, toilet paper, and flour and oil. Let's do flour. Yep. Okay, cool. It's good that you stream on Twitch because the broadcast on YouTube freezes for me. Yeah, I had that happen today too for me where I was watching somebody on Twitch and then I had to go watch them on YouTube. Looks like now finally because Twitch undid the whole like, oh dude, you can only stream on Twitch thing. It's nice to see Twitch streamers streaming everywhere. On Twitch, on TikTok, on YouTube. And it's the same for me. So we can kind of build the Twitch channel and branch out. Like, our Twitch channel is kind of technically new. I streamed on Twitch for like 2 or 3 years. And then, I continuously applied for the Twitch Partner Program to be able to get emotes and stuff. And they kept saying like, no. You have to have a certain number of like this and that. And it's like, well, okay then. And then YouTube came along and allowed for streaming. And they basically let you have emotes and stuff right from the beginning for free. Like, you didn't have to apply or anything like that. Or, well, I guess I didn't because I was already part of the YouTube Partner Program, but I didn't have to do anything special, so... So YouTube was kind of just the better thing, so I streamed only here for a while. Twitch contacted me at some point through that, like on year 4 out of those 8 years, Twitch was like, hey, do you want to come stream over on Twitch? Like, we want to have a one-on-one meeting with you, dude. If you come over and stream on Twitch, we'll provide you absolutely nothing, and you can't stream on YouTube anymore. How does that sound? It's like, horrible. You can't, like 4 years ago, it was like, yeah, if you stream over on Twitch, can't stream on YouTube anymore. Like, you have to be, like, exclusively over here on Twitch if you're a partner or whatever. There was a few weird things, and I was like, wow, that sounds absolutely horrible. But now they've lightened that up, so that's good. Everybody should be able to stream and watch wherever they want, and the better platform should just win. It's the same with, like, games, where it's like, yeah... Epic Game Store is pretty cool for all the free games that they give away every Thursday. They give away like 2 free games that people can just go download. Which, if you don't like Epic, I think you should still go download that free Epic game because it's one less game that maybe you'll spend money on Steam, and it gives you more Steam money to buy stuff. So, think about it. If you buy, or if you were about to buy Red Dead Redemption 2, but it comes out on Epic for free, well then suddenly you've saved, I don't know, 20, 30 bucks. And then that means you can go buy like 1 or 2 games over on Steam. Pretty cool. So it's like free Steam money. That's how I see it. Use code Raptoria at checkout. What's up, Fredneck? Good to see you. Welcome back. All right, we got $513. This is great. This is a wonderful day in the store because we got actual like money to spend. And we got a lot of products on the shelves too. I think we need some more sushi. I think we need the small sushi. These items are getting real expensive, though. The sushi and stuff are getting real spendy. Let's try it. Let's try the small. Actually, what if we do a big and a small? Okay, I have enough for that. And then maybe some sugar? Yep, sugar. Oh, the oils. Yeah, GOG. Yeah, GOG is a wonderful platform as well. Absolutely. I have a few games on there as well. I feel like I never mention it because people then go like, what's that? Okay, let's just go with one and then we're good. I miss this original Sims music. It's so good. Yo, Dire Spitfire, thanks for the 100 Twitch bits. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Ooh, keeping that hype train going. 7 seconds left on that one. Got us up to 68%. Oh, we were one away from 69. That would have been nice. Oh, well. There's always next time. Thank you, chat, for all the support. When will the customers come? As soon as I open the store. You just hit this button here, but I'm waiting for our stockers to... They got to put stuff on the shelves first. And then we'll open our store. I'm also thinking about getting another cashier spot so I can start doing cashiering, but I think what I want to do is expand the store first before we do that. Because I don't think there's any space here for me. Yesterday I made a mistake and shortchanged a buyer by 10 cents. Immediately started shouting, theft. Buyers are so gentle. Oh, yeah. Okay, I think we're ready to open the store. Yep, let's go. Let's begin our day. Let's begin our day. Let's go. Yeah. You've been watching since the Stranded Deep days? Oh, good. That was a great game. I enjoyed Stranded Deep. I actually want to play it again because I think a year or two ago it got co-op multiplayer. And I beat it alone, but I feel like co-op would be a whole different experience. I'd love to play that with like Bradford or She-Fox or something. And I would also like to do that with Raft too. I feel like most of my Raft playthrough was like single player. Like I started with a group of people, then they all got busy, then they got kind of free towards the middle. It was like they joined me at the beginning of the game, like right at the start of the stream, and then like somewhere around that floating city, the dome city, and then people were busy until the very end. And then I was like, oh, it's fine. People get busy. Bum, 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 bum. I really hope that this game, by the way, I mentioned it the other day. We've got Gas Station Simulator. We got Supermarket Simulator. I want to see a multiplayer fast food restaurant management game. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like there's still plenty of fast food restaurants that are not massive. Like, maybe there's 3 or 4 or 5 locations, and they're kind of like a local franchise. But I feel like, why don't we have a 4-player fast food place where, like, someone has to manage the drive-thru, someone has to manage the grill and the fries, and somebody has to manage, like, you know, restocking things like cups and cleaning up the dining room, and somebody has to manage all the cash. That seems like the perfect multiplayer game. It kind of sounds like, you know, Cook, Serve, Delicious, or, like, Overcooked. But I feel like it should be more like this. Now, we did play a game called Kebab Simulator with Indrid Morgan and Harry recently. That game is still in early access, too, where things do... they're a little bit more on how you prepare the food rather than like how you lay out the restaurant and stuff like that. But I guess this is the same thing, too. You could totally lay out your grocery store haphazardly and people will still figure it out. Chicken's too expensive, ma'am? Oh, $8.78. Thank you for saying something. We'll make that $9. All right, price check. Boy, prices really went down. Oh, holy crap, what happened? Eh, that's fine. Oh, $20. $13.04. Ooh, $7 and $5.75. Jeez, what a difference. $3.80, good. $2.50. Got the Brambor there. Yeah, that's fine. I think prices are looking okay. We'll see if anybody else complains. You know what's another... what I'd like to see, too, is hopefully when we get the security camera stuff and theft and whatnot, it'd be cool to, like, hang out in the manager's office and be able to, like, see the cameras to see everybody's responses to things, too. Okay, it looks like we're low or out of sushi. I'm going to stock those myself. I think that guy wanted the small sushi. Or is this the big? Oh, that's the grande. That's the Ariana Grande sushi. Ooh, baby. The small sushi looked huge. This is like the mega. There you go, sir. There we go. It's interesting to actually have money to be able to buy the products now, like during the middle of the day. We were hurting so bad. We were so bad. It was so bad. We were like spending almost 500 and something bucks a day on just interest, and then another, I don't know, 200 on, like, we were in total, it was like $750 a day that we were spending on just, like, expenses and loan interest and stuff, and not actually managing this place, but we saved the day. Okay. Oh, it looks like we need more pasta again. How's flour doing? And maybe we should get some more flour. Pasta and flour. People in this town love bread and pasta. What is the other thing? Flour? Yeah. And two more things to buy. I think we could squeeze in some other stuff. Maybe a couple boxes of cereal? More tea. More tea. We'll do two of those. Oh. Can you hire with stalkers now? Yep, sure did. We got two of them working already. You'll see them walking around in blue. And then we're going to... I think we're going to expand the storage room now, because clearly we're getting a ton of products. But I think our main goal right now should be, instead of that, maybe we should use all of our money to buy... you know, to like make sure we have enough products on every shelf, and then make sure we've got the storage shelf ready to go too. Steam and Epic are in deep competition. Meanwhile, people who work at Nvidia aren't even sure if they sell games. You want me to sell a fondue mix? I had fondue. I enjoyed it. It was an interesting experience. I think it was also starting to become a little under the... I don't know what happened. It was an interesting experience. It was good, though. I want to try it again. I don't know if my body was used to eating just pure liquid cheese. As an American, you'd think I was, like, training my whole life for an experience like that. But, wow, we're up to 17... Oh, my God, we're making so much money. How are we making all this money? All right, we should probably buy the super expensive stuff, then. Let's make sure we're stocked on the super spendy. Let's go with veal, sushi, steak, scallop, salmon... The new stuff we bought. Oh, that's gonna be $1,700. Ooh, baby. Maybe another salmon. Okay, so we need $1,800. We'll buy that tomorrow, maybe. Yeah, the storage shelves and the stockers are game changers, because if you were playing this without having the people helping, you would just have to, like, triple down. Like, you'd have to have three shelves for every product, because you would not have enough. You would have had to play a little differently, actually. Because, like, for example, toilet paper takes up a massive amount of space. So here we have room for, like, what, 2, 4, 6, 8. So 16. Like, we could put 16 toilet paper here. But then for a product like chocolate, we could probably put, like, what is that? 3 by 4 times 4. So... And I don't know how demand works in this game. Like, there's certain products that people absolutely need. Chocolate's kind of more of a luxury item and not a necessity, as we're like, things like milk, eggs, and cheese, you'd imagine people would kind of see as a necessity. Cheese boot camp in the Alps for a month. Oh, that's cool. That'd be cool. I'd do that. It's nice to just snack on, like, a little thing of high-quality cheese and a little wine. I always thought that was kind of a snooty, weird thing that people just faked that they enjoyed, but I could see why they enjoy it now. Because it's about the, I don't know, like, the... When I had some of that cheese, it, like, I could feel it in, like, the bottom of my cheeks, and I was like, I've never had that experience before. Okay, now we got $1,800, so we can definitely start our day tomorrow with all the new products. Another thing holding us back now is the cash registers. There's a lot of people coming into the store, and the game will only spawn so many. So we got to make sure we get one more cash register. But more important than that, stocking all these shelves. And yeah, a side of prunes. Hey, look at this! Hey, look at that! We went from like 33 products not found to 3. Three too expensive and three three not found. That's great. And one of them, I think, was the sushi that I bought towards the end. So, big money masuk. Uh-oh, Brambor is a little expensive now. All right, let's make our purchase. Oh, we had a little expenses. I'll just buy one of everything then. There we go. 404 sushi not found. Yeah. Can we enlarge the room? Yeah, you can build the you can make the grocery store bigger and the storage room, but of course that takes money. So we're waiting on that. The first thing I'm going to do, we're going to just stock all the shelves and make sure all the products are in place. And then we're going to make sure the storage is a little full. We got backup, and then it's just pure profits. And then we do our club card. You know, save 10% on your purchase by giving all your personal information to us so we can market to you. So you do a third party. And then self-checkouts. Sell us, give us, surrender your personal information voluntarily. You do the checkouts. You go grow the crops. You drive them to the store. You make the products. You buy the products. You check out. And then you pay us, you know, for our service. You're addicted to me playing this? Oh, it's a great game. It's a really good game. All right, let's do a little price check. That's fine. I think we're... If we're 5 cents either way, I think we're okay. Like, if we're 5 cents over or 5 cents below, I'm fine with that. I'm totally fine with that. Oh. Okay, we'll do 950. I feel like that's going to fluctuate anyway. Bump, 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 bump. 275 for milk. That's good. Oh, cheese. Butter, I mean. Should probably have 2 shelves of butter. I'm going to fix that when I can. What is this? Oh, scallop gratin. Yogurt, $2. Yeah, that's fine. Wow, $13.70 for this moussaka. That's fine. Oh, these are steaks. I want to move these over to this aisle, I think. In the future. Cheese Queen, thank you very much for following. Who the hell was that? Alright, yeah, the luxury aisle. Mm-hmm. $5.40 for eggs. Wow. Cheese is at $4. Yep, that's fine. Is at $2.50 out of $2.30. That's fine. Toilet paper, $13.82. Definitely going to go buy some boxes of that. I think we'll probably buy 5 boxes of that. Oh, and then we should do some cleaner and some tablets. Hello from Thailand. Hello. Welcome. Bum, 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 bum. Oh. Tablets. Do 2 of those. Wait, is that... Are we over budget? Oh, we're at 430, 473. Okay, cleaner. And then I'll buy some bleach, too. Okay, so we gotta get to $500. Okay, so we're good here. 18, yep. Oh, wait a minute. 18, 80, oh, 66. Okay, 8305, good. Okay, blue flour, red flour is good, right? 551? What, 550? Okay, that's fine. 1304... Whoa, 2078. Okay, we'll do $20.80. We'll do... Yep, $21. Let's see what happens. That's fine. That's some big O grande sushi right there. $10 for salmon. Look at that salmon. That's so... That's a weird box. It's almost like a like what you would buy bacon in. Like you have that, you know, the slab of bacon that's kind of cut and then like spread out like cards or whatever. That's so small for salmon. Like it's like prosciutto. But salmon. Okay, I think we're good. Okay. Smoked salmon? Something. It just says Norway salmon. Norway, dude. Okay, let's go. And did I check these? I think we're fine. Looks like bacon? I know. Vacuum packed? Apparently. Hell of a vacuum. Is this game like employee training for Kroger or something? You know, a really good YouTube video that I saw maybe last year was somebody trying to find a Nintendo DS official game that was made by McDonald's for Nintendo. And so McDonald's in Japan would purchase a bunch of like Game Boy DSs or Game Boy Advance. I can't remember which one. But anyway, McDonald's paid Nintendo to make a McDonald's game that would then be played on the DS that was basically employee training. So basically Japanese McDonald's employees would play Nintendo DS, an official game made by McDonald's, on how to do certain things. So instead of like teaching them, you know, like looking at a user manual or something like that, they would each of the jobs, like working on frying the fries or filling the cups or handing money to the customer, would all be, it was almost like playing Nintendogs or something like that, or something. I don't know. I've seen the game. It's very cool. They had one of the problems was somebody had to figure out what the code was. Each of the McDonald's branches in Japan had a code that would unlock the game. So if you pop the game into a DS, it wouldn't work. You had to like learn this code, and somebody figured out what the code was. And man, it seems pretty damn cool. Okay, we're at 356. Yeah, like how to make a double cheeseburger? Yeah. That's kind of games I want to play. Oh, we're at 528. Okay. Well, not too much more. Bum, 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 bum. Full Spectrum Warrior was that way from the U.S. Army? Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Isn't that the game where if you shot people in the training area, you just end up in Leavenworth? I think you'd play the harmonica or something. Raptor streams have a secret code. You push the like button, subscribe, and set notification bells to all. Nobody's going to do it. You tell me everybody watching right now would hit the like button to let me know and YouTube know they'd like to see more and be recommended more of whatever that just was. No way. No way if your name is Jose, or possibly it's Patrick, or maybe Devin. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, I think when I was in Europe, I had the McDonald's for the first time in like 2 years or something like that. Still feels kind of dirty going there, but honestly, it's been a while, and I guess it was a good experiment to see how things work there, and there is a difference. I actually felt like a human. With a number instead of just being a number, I was a human with a number attached. Purchase, consume. Amazon delivers in this game, it does to my house. Oh, yeah, that's a feature that's going to be coming in the future, is that people will order stuff from your supermarket and then you can deliver it to their house. So you can do like door-to-door delivery and stuff like that in the future. Apparently you'll be able to get a vehicle and you'll be able to drive to places and pick up like groceries and stuff for cheaper. Like there'll be other, instead of just ordering it online, oh my God. Instead of just ordering things online and having it dumped on the curb, eventually there'll be different businesses to get different products from, different wholesalers, And then you will be able to go and drive your van and be able to go get those products, which makes it infinitely more interesting to manage your store because then each day is just going to take a lot longer, which is kind of cool because, yeah, at the start of the day, you'd hopefully before the store opened, you'd get in the vehicle and go get whatever is needed and then stock it. And then, you know, you'd be doing all the work at 7 and 8 and then open up the store at like 9 or something like that, 9 to 5 or, well, in this case, 9 to 9. 9 to 9, Rotluftballons. Okay, let's do a quick product check. I'm gonna buy more butter, yogurt, eggs, and cheese. Butter, yogurt, eggs, cheese, flour. Workplace injury. What was something else we needed? Flour. And then maybe there'll be a way where if you can buy a delivery van, you'll be able to hold more products than what they have here. Like, buying 10 at a time, not really that much. Like, 10 boxes of stuff is kind of small. Any game pad support coming? Oh, there might be game pad support coming, yeah. I'd imagine with a game like this that's blown up all over, you know, all over the internet plus Steam, they'll be working on everything. It's a fun game. Trippy, thank you very much for the 51 months. Thank you very much for your support. Awesome, thank you. Boy, the Sims 1 music is really delightful. I like it. Oh, boy, we got a line. Come on, folks, two of you go over here. Come on, this guy's wide open. There's nobody over here. Candy. Candy, milk, and maybe some cereals and bread. Am I having fun? I am, yeah. I like this game. What else did I say? Yeah, the milk. And maybe peanut butter? Mm-hmm. Oh, closed after 9. Sad. Alright, we'll wait for everyone to check out. And then, boy. I think before we expand the store again, there is an opportunity for some more shelf space. Like, one, we could probably buy 2 more shelves here. Well, I gotta move the steaks and stuff over here. Is there honey to sell? There might be honey in the game. I'm not sure. We have to unlock things by, like, buying licenses to sell them. I want this just to be the dairy aisle. I'm gonna move all the steaks to the other side. Yeah, this game simulates being a cashier too, yep. So that's done. Let's put cheese here. And then eggs there. And then I guess I could try to... Oh, wait. I want butter. I want to put butter there. I think butter needs the very small box. Okay. And then, do we have butter? We do. So two shelves for butter. Yogurt. Wow, this is looking a lot more organized. This is beautiful. Then we're going to order stuff tomorrow. Okay, we probably should get some more chicken. Apparently we put veal there. Okay. Yeah, we're still moving things around. It's going to get real nice here in a minute. Yeah, we got milk here. Yep. Dairy aisle's pretty good already. No, we don't have ice cream yet. Nope. So what we can do is if I unlock more products, the customers will immediately start wanting those things. So one of the problems about buying a new license is that it costs like a couple $1,000 to unlock the new products. Then you got to buy the new products, which are probably going to be a couple $1,000 because we're getting towards the high tier fancy stuff. And we need shelf space to put them on. So we'll need a couple $100 to buy new shelves and maybe expand the grocery store. So it's going to take some money. But we'll deal with that tomorrow. Dude, two more days to day 69. Nice. Bum, 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 bum. All right, next day. Man, we're making a lot of cash now, though. I think what my goal should be here is to try to unlock every product and sell every product in the game. If we can do that, we should try to do that. But I also like making it so things are kind of organized. Like, I feel like, you know, if you go into the aisle with all the cereal, it should be, you know, all breakfast items plus the bread. Like, it just kind of... I like how I've set things up. You think honey is an early license? It could be. I don't even know what I have done yet. Let's see. If we go to, what, management? Product license. There you go. We got things like... Yeah, there it is. Honey. So honey is here. More cheese. More bottled water. More crab sticks. I mean, look at all these things. Holy hell. Level 90. We can start selling wine and whiskey. Toothpaste at level 81. Books. Oh, we can have like a magazine rack at like level 81. More chips and cakes. Cat food and dog food at level 70. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff here. Sugar. Different types of soda, chips. Yeah. So you can imagine the absolute amazing amount of shelf space we're going to need for all this. But our store looks nice, so that's good. All right, we need Brambor and juice. Candy, chocolate, milk. I need that milk too, the other milk. Bum 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 bum. Yeah, we have to excel. Yeah, it's you know how it is. It's you got to basically pull multiple levers at a time. If you want to sell more products, then you need more floor space. Once you buy the floor space, then you need shelf space. You got to work like that. First, you need the floor space, then you need the shelf space, then you need the license, then you need the products. You have to do it in that order. Because having a huge store with one shelf in it ain't going to make you a lot of money. But I've been trying to... Man, it would be great to have a Japanese... I would love to have a Japanese dev, somebody from Japan, make one that you get to manage your own Lawson's or Family Mart or something like that, and they made it that theme. Like, this neighborhood's very much like Brooklyn or something like that, but I'd love to see it, like, near a Shinkansen station or something. Amazing. Yeah, there will be expiring... products will expire in the future, yeah. All the things that you'd imagine that this game should have will be coming. We looked at the list the other day, and it's pretty comprehensive. We need more oils. Oil and sugar. And we needed potato. Potato. Different themed grocery stores. That'd be great. I'd love to see that. Some that, appealed to different palates and communities and stuff like that. Absolutely. For sure. Beauty options? Chat, when you look like me, you don't use any beauty products. It'd be a waste of money. Okay, we should get some more chicken. Maybe we'll buy 2 boxes of chicken. More yogurt. And more, what is this, moussaka? What was the other thing I needed? Yogurt. Okay, what else? Maybe cereal? 2 on cereal. And then 2 more. Coffee. Maybe coffee. Coffee and... sodas. I will buy some more greens. And we'll need to buy that moussaka stuff. I guess I got that, okay. Am I gonna play Taxi Life? We might have that on our schedule. ! Scheduled in the chat. And or the description of any video or live stream should show you what's up next. At some point, I think we will. Could have different scenarios like running a... health food store. Yeah. And it would be interesting, too, to have one like at a airport or something like that. Like, sometimes they have kind of convenience stores at the airport that sell... chocolate and magazines and snacks. But yeah, ! Scheduled to see what we're up to next. You guys won't miss a stream, right? You're all subscribed with the notification bell turned on and turned on to all, and you're here for every single stream regardless of the content, right? You love being in the community and hanging and chatting. At least that's what it seems. Could you imagine missing a stream? No, I wouldn't even mention that. This never happened. No one here has ever missed a stream.
Hmm.
More flour. Man, why is flour so popular? Everybody in this town is a baker. I gotta fix that soda section. Great, imagine when we sell more of this stuff. You've missed a straight security? We'll have security help you out. Okay. Oh. Oh yeah, all those little lemonade stand simulators and stuff. Yeah, those are fun. Where you get to like buy cups and then you work on the mix for lemon versus sugar. And I think there were a lot of great little flash games on like all the fun little flash game websites that had tons of those. Oh, we gotta get rid of these. Okay. We'll let the stalkers keep doing their thing. Do we buy another freezer? I think for right now, I think we're okay. Yeah, we got plenty of freezer space, I think. Oh, I gotta see how the soda's organized. Okay, I need to switch around the orange juice. You level 49, you feel like a manager of a stock room? That's good. That's kind of what I want to do, is the more product management stuff now. Where'd they put those sodas? Here. Okay, so these are those. I don't know how I want to organize this. I think I'll do it like this. Sir? Okay. Oh, that'll be temporary there. Yeah, they will fix that lack of moving box thing in the future, too. No, whatever. Okay, that's better, I think. They're not buying as many greens as they're buying the other ones, I think, but we'll work it out. Okay, so maybe some more cereal. We got some more cash to spend. Let's do cereal, pasta, peanut butter, maybe some hand soap, flour. I feel like we're going through like 4 boxes a day of pasta of flour. Yeah, what's up, D-Pad Dad? Good to see you. Welcome. I will keep organizing those. Okay, we'll buy more purple cereal. And I think I bought that pasta. Oh, also, I looked at the roadmap for Big Ambitions, and they're going to have rivals and stuff soon, finally. So there's going to be more competition and stuff coming down the line. Good to see. Do cereal. Two things of toilet paper, and let's do more tablets. Damn it. There. Bum, 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 bum. Will I ever do City Skylines again? Well, whenever I have something planned in the future, I will definitely put it on our schedule. I would like to return to that game, and I feel like I have enjoyed playing that more than people have enjoyed watching that more recently. But I think it's just everyone was kind of bummed out that it was not a game that... There were some issues where people didn't want to watch it or play it. But I'll return to it. But we'll definitely have that on our schedule soon. I think the biggest issue is that there were issues. Every game has issues. But some of those issues were kind of... mods of City Skylines 1 were kind of like a golden highway of already solving those problems. Like, City Skylines 1 was amazing. No one can argue against that. City Skylines 1, vanilla, amazing. DLCs, outstanding. Mods, mind absolutely blown. But that game was made like back in 2013-14 and then came out in like 2015. So... you know, now with the new game out, it should have kind of removed a lot of technological barriers that, you know, there were things that couldn't be done back in the day that should now be able to be done. That are not. I want to thank the person who donated me a membership. You guys are one of the best communities around. I know. Chat drops gift bombs left and right. Exclamation point gift, by the way, in the YouTube chat. If you want to be gifted a membership, you never know. It's my birthday week, too, so chat's could get kind of feisty, especially on Saturday, which is my birthday. I'll be streaming from PAX East, and I hope you all come and say hi on my birthday and in a live event at a cool little thing known as PAX. Pretty cool. Okay, before I open, we need to do, like, one last check. I feel like... oh, I don't have that marked for cereal. That's why they're not putting it there. Okay. We'll fix that. Cool. And same with the pasta here. So these are the problems I need to fix. Now that we got the money to do so. The last stream was an absolute brutal grind. Oh yeah, exclamation point P.O. box too, if you'd like to send anything for my birthday. We do have a P.O. box. And I went and checked that as well. There were some things in there too. Looks like developers are sending me stuff now in my P.O. box. I got a really cool poster from a developer. They were like, hey, we saw your P.O. box and we sent over a poster. And I was like, oh, that's nice. It's for, I forget how to say the name of this game. Grim something, I forgot. I always forget the name of that one. Oh, let me tab out so I don't forget. My bad. It was Gord. Gord sent it over. Gord sent over some really cool, like, actual physical art. What's PAX? PAX stands for Penny Arcade Expo, and it's held in different locations around the U.S. PAX East happens to be in Boston this year, and it's where a bunch of developers from all over the world, really, get together to show off their games. Right now in San Francisco, there's one live called GDC, Game Developer Conference, and not only does it show off games, but also hardware. Like, I think NVIDIA's there, and Intel, and everybody else, they're showing off, like, the latest graphic cards and latest features for their systems and things like that, and then also game developers show up too. And I always was debating, like, I don't know if I ever want to go to an event, and I don't want to go alone. So if I ever go to, like, Gamescom, it'll be like, I'll have to get you guys to come along with me. It's like, is anyone near, you know, Germany? Does anyone want to, like, take a cool train and kind of go to Gamescom, but more importantly, just go see Cologne and stuff like that? That'll probably happen at least once. It was meant as a replacement for E3. Yeah, I honestly think E3 needs to come back. I hope it comes back and with a big vengeance. I really do. Because I like how everybody was kind of forced to do stuff on, like, a 3-day period. I loved it. People would say, oh, such and such won E3 or whatever. I feel like we always won E3 because you'd have 3 days of just, like, Nintendo, Sony, and Xbox, and then PC games all showing their best stuff in the middle of the year. Like, they were trying to really have a middle-of-the-year, like, wow factor. But now there's, like, you know, there's the PlayStation State of Play. Like, there's all these random events that can happen at random times. And it was just nice for 3 days to just have, like, a huge thing to just watch for, like, almost like the whole week, because there'd be like 3 days of presentations, but then it would go beyond that of, like, all these different trailers and stuff. I don't know. I always just love watching trailers with you guys. Yeah. Mon, you'd go to that? You'd go to Gamescom? Yeah. I'd love to go with all of my gaming friends. Other streamers? Yeah, we'll get Floppy Sword to go, Lumberjack, Mon. Everybody can come. All the channel owners. All you guys who have channels can come. And everybody who wants to say hello to us. All of our friends. That'd be cool. Alright, I think we're looking good here, right? I should maybe buy some more pasta, maybe? Let me just do a shelf check, though. Let's make sure we've got no shelves empty. Although these will be empty because we're going to unlock some more products for those. Dude, I think we're good. Man, these are the most full shelves I've seen in a long time. Wow. Let's do salt. What about Moussaka? Do we have that? Did I? Oh, yes. I wanted to add 2 more boxes for that. Well, yeah, okay. E3 from 98 to 2006 was goated. Yeah. Yeah, I really enjoyed the PS3, PS4 era of E3. Like, those years. But same for, like, Xbox and stuff, too. It was just, I don't know. It was always a treat to watch games. Games were presented in a different way. I don't know. You live outside Boston? Amen, brother. Buy some more shampoo, more of these little cakey, snacky cakes, and maybe some fries. Oh, and we're out of money. Okay, time to open the store. Let's go. Alert. Alert. The store has opened. All employees, battle stations. Prepare to make them purchase and consume. Oh, we need some peanut butter too? Okay. Yep, peanut butter. That's why I try to at least give everything 2 shelves, at least. Yeah, some of my favorite events to do with you guys, though, is when we just, like, when I just go live and we're just watching, like, a presentation of gaming, I love getting excited. Hell, I love, you know, people are saying that my City Skylines 2 reaction aged poorly. And it's like, well, look, how was I supposed to know? On the other hand, I don't think there's anything wrong with getting excited for games. Because we all know that there's always the hype and the expectation. And then there's kind of like the reality or whatnot. We always know it's not as not always as it seems. But then some things are also better, too. Like, for example, Helldivers. Like, I don't think I saw any videos or any marketing or anything related to Helldivers other than Bradford saying, like, dude, Helldivers came out. What are you going to get it? It's like, no, dude, I don't think I want to play that game. Well, wait, it's like Starship Troopers? All right, maybe I'll give it a try. And there was, like, no other marketing for it. And now the marketing is just everybody ever playing it. But that seems to be a thing now, right? Since COVID, it seems like more than ever... I feel like every 2 months we get a game that just explodes. Like, we get Among Us, then Fall Guys, then Helldivers, then Lethal Company. And we just keep getting these games that are kind of like... It feels like anybody can play them. They're not overly complicated. They're very... I love that. I don't know. There's just something really cool about that. Now, my sunglasses are from They Live. That's right. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it was just my honest reaction. Like, I got excited as hell to see the trailer. I was excited for the trailer. Like, oh my God. But you know, honestly, I'm starting to realize that these Starfield and City Skylines 2 had very good, very good marketing campaigns. They made those games look like they were the best games to ever be games. They did an incredible job. Like, remember with City Skylines 2 where every week they were dropping like a whole new feature thing where it would like teach you a little bit more about each of them? That was kind of cool. I just like being excited. It's exciting. Yeah, Pacific Drive, yeah. Yeah, there was no real well, there was a little marketing around that one, but I gotta say, though, I really liked Pacific Drive. The ending was just... there was a little... I kind of rushed it because I had to go on my vacation. And also, there wasn't too much more to do in some of those end areas. Once you get to, like, the last area, which is really cool and really fascinating. Since that's the end area, you can already kind of survive there, so there's nothing to work towards other than your own goals of pimping out the car and maybe finding remaining stickers and, like, cosmetics or whatever. But I want to play it more. I really do. Outer Worlds 2 trailer has me hyped. Well, I think you guys told me about Outer Worlds. You want me to play that in the Outer Wilds. I should make a list of chat games that chat really wants me to play, and then we'll just kind of have you guys vote on some. And we will start with Red Dead Redemption 2 this year. Then I'll do a little bit of Kingdom Come. And I want to be very careful that I don't get into... Here's how this channel's got to go, chat. Like, we got to pick, like, two or maybe three games that are endless, like this game, right? Where we just can constantly just, like, play it. Like, you could basically play this game forever. It's the same with City Skylines. It's the same with, like, Farming Simulator or Stardew Valley. Like, you could literally just play those games forever. But we got to have some games that we can roll credits on. And I got to do better with, like, getting through those. Like, Last Train Home and Banishers. What is it called? Ghosts of New Eden. Good game. Am I on any panels or Q&As at PAX? Yes, I have a panel with Astragon, which are the folks who make Construction Simulator. That's why I was so damn excited. Construction Simulator. They also make Railroads Online. So construction, vehicles, trains, and then high-speed chases. They got a new police DLC coming out, or like a Highway Patrol DLC. So it's like, whoa. It's my year, baby. Let's buy some milk. Buy some more candy. Maybe bread. Milk, candy, bread. We gotta do something about these lines. That'll be our next thing. What else should we buy? Bottle wall. Buy three things of milk. Luckily, it never goes bad, so we're good. Dune Awakening. I'm excited for that. Yep. I feel like I'm on Saturday Night Live. Bum, 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 bum. Outer Wilds is the most important game I ever played. It's art. Yeah, I think we'll do that. I think two years ago I played Subnautica for the first time too. I feel like there's some really important, not games that are good, but games that are like important that I should play. Like, Subnautica's good, but I feel like it goes beyond that. I feel like that's an important game to play. Kind of like a milestone in gaming. It's like if you haven't played a city builder. Like, everybody should have, at this point, like, played a city builder. And, like, a theme park builder, too. Well, Chad, I think we could expand the store. I think we should get another checkout. I think if we buy a spot for the store, we'll get this corner here. And then we can push these back into the corner. And we'll get that going. Man, look at all these people in here, dude. I think self-checkout will be a thing in the future, too, in the game. Good music, man. Take out a loan from the mob. What is this? The gas station simulator? I already fought my way out of that loan debt. My uncle tried to get me in trouble with the mob. Man, see? Alright, what else? What can we do here? I guess we'll set up for the next day. More tea, more pasta, more candy. Tea, pasta, candy, peanut butter. Bear simulator? There probably is. All right, we'll let the cashiers finish that up tomorrow. Wow, look at that. A perfect score. 53 satisfied customers and no problems at all. Beautiful. I love how a Ferrari rolls by and it sounds like a diesel engine on like a Volkswagen Golf or something. Is there a legit forklift sim game? I think there is, yeah. I mean, technically, the beer simulator game had a lot to do with the forklift. We were doing a lot of stuff with the forklift in beer simulator. All right, what do we need to buy more of this store? How do we expand the store? Ooh, whoa, what? Whoa, whoa. $6,700 to expand the store? Are they kidding me? Whoa. Wow. Look at how big the store can get. 23 expansions, level 99. Oh, look at the last expansion. That's a lot of zeros. Wow. Wow. Jeez. Wow. Wow. All right. Well, I mean, yeah. I think I should buy another cat. Here's what we should do. Let's throw these chickens into the corner, and we'll buy another cash register, and we'll start helping out with the checkout. That's what we're going to start doing. We're going to get more throughput now. I think we figured everything out now. Like, we got, you know, we got money coming in. Money's coming in. So I'm going to start changing things. I'll put this in the corner. Okay, let's buy another cash register. Oh, these guys are still stocking the shelves. Oh, can I get another... Actually, wait. If we expand the storage room, we could hire another person, too, to stock shelves. We need 13... Oh, wow. We need 13 racks in the storage room. Well, let's start with the cash register. Oh, that says mirrored. Uh-oh. Okay. So then we can just, you know, box this up whenever we don't need it. That'll just be my own personal. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. Put it more there. All right, that's fine. That's my personal one. Let's buy some more steaks. Oh, they're still stocking the shelves. Let's buy cereal. Yeah, we'll get all those stacked up. This music's great. There's a game called Forklift Simulator 2023. It's on Epic Game Store for $8. Really? All right, then. Okay, we have $300 left. What else should we buy? I want more of that moussaka on the shelf. Not that shampoo. Oh, there it is. Bum, bum, bum. Yeah, it feels good to reorganize all the shelves. Looks like we want some more eggs. We need eggs. Buy four of those. Okay, I guess we'll open up while we wait. Peanut butter and salt. Maybe a thing of butter? Wow, the store looks amazing. Wow. Well, let's buy some of that. Did I buy rice? We need rice. Yeah, I would love to see that in the back. Like the deli counter and like the bakery and stuff like that. I would love to see the different sections. All right, we just need a little bit of cash. Let's open up for the day. Oh, and we get to run the register, so that's cool. Hi, bro. The store's looking nice. Well, thank you very much, Matt. Appreciate that. Can I talk much about the Police Simulator DLC? Well, I don't know much, which is why I'm going to PAX East. Essentially, it's going to be a sponsored stream where Astragon is paying for my flight to PAX East, and then they're paying for my time to basically sit and ask questions of them and ask about the game. So there's a few things I know from the trailer, but essentially they're paying me to go there and ask them questions about it. For all you guys. So when I'm there, you guys are more than welcome to be in the chat and just hammer out questions, and I'll try to ask questions that you're asking in the chat. And then I have questions of my own too, and not just for Police Simulator too, but I have questions on like Construction Sim, which I like Construction Sim just a little bit more than Police Sim, because Police Sim I think is two player, like you play as an officer and their partner, but with the Construction Sim that's four players. But Railroads Online is like 30 to 64 or something crazy like that. And I love trains. So I love construction equipment. I love trains. And I do love myself some high-speed chases. So it's all a win for me. Ask them if there's any bears in the DLC. All right, I'm not going. Canceled. Canceled. Nice work. Well done. Well, it's because of your guys' support. It's not like I did this on my own. I got to go on a lovely vacation and meet many friends, and have met many friends because of all your guys' support. So thank you. Okay, 60 cents. Wow, this feels so weird to do. What, 50 cents? There's a 50 cent piece? The hell? I don't remember that. The hell? Wait, what? Oh. It's been so long since I've worked the register. New firefighting sim? Oh yeah, they did in their if you go to on my channel right now, there is a if you go to the live stream that's scheduled for Saturday, there's a little trailer for it, and it does show some of the other game that they published called Firefighters the Squad, which I played that with Alex and Lumberjack and Dirty and Thurston. I love that game. They got some good games. They just got to add some more content to them. Whoa, ma'am. $161.95. Thank you. Thank you for coming to Member Mart, home of the Member Marts. Wow. Oh, yeah. Multiplayer in this game would be amazing, yes. Of course. And you know what would be interesting is if it were multiplayer and competitive against friends. It's one thing to like run a store together and stock the shelves, that'd be fine. But to be able to compete against each other would be really interesting. I don't know how they would do that, but it would be kind of cool if there was like exclusivity deals you could acquire that would give you like a little, maybe you'd get a discount on like eggs and rice so you could sell them at a little cheaper price. But maybe your friend then goes on some sort of a, maybe they do something different to get an advantage. Like decorations or something. I don't know. I don't know. Ba-bum, ba-bum, ba-bum. Hello, sir. card it is. That's 3630. What else do we want to buy? Man, I'm glad we hired so many stalkers. It's good to keep all the... It's nice to see all the products full. Hello, ma'am. Welcome to the store. No change. Oh, $1,500? Let's go, baby. $0.45, okay. Things are looking good. More peanut butter, I think. Peanut butter and cleaner and tablets. Maybe some more oils, too. Hello, sir. You know, honestly, I like the checkout system of this game more than in, In this game, it's kind of more about, like, handling the money. But in Gas Station Simulator, it's kind of like a product come... I feel like it's buggy. A product comes down the conveyor belt, and 90% of the time, I'll, like, reach for a product, and then it'll just fly off the conveyor belt. And it's like, how did that even happen? Like, I'm not throwing products. Boop, boop, boop. There. Go, go, go. Bam, bam, bam. You have yet to get FarmSim 22. You have FarmSim 19. Oh, yeah. I'm sure eventually it'll be, like, free on the Epic Game Store. I've had tons of fun with Farming Sim. I can't wait till the next one comes out, and then we'll just get locked into it. That'll do. Oh, he couldn't find bleach. Oh, okay. Put that on our list for tomorrow, then. Order at least four of those. coffee, pasta. Ooh, we got 3,000 bucks now. Okay. Now we're in business, folks. Now we're in business. Coffee and pasta. Now, yeah, that's the new Dirty's new podcast. Oh, good. Are we all done? Everybody left? Okay. All right, we had like, only one product not found and one product found expensive. Not bad. Beautiful. Our bills are only 184. That's good. That's nothing. Yeah, cheesy pancakes. Well, that's probably who's coming in and buying all of our flour and cheese. Is the dirty one himself. All right, let's get some chicken going. Chicken soap. We'll see what else we got. Bum, 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 bum. Let's see. I'm glad we have all these guys doing the stocking, though. It's so nice. Bum, 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 bum. Yeah, reorganizing the aisles and like making everything look nice is good for our own. I mean, there's probably ways you could do things where it's like optimized for gameplay, but sometimes it's just nice to do things how they would probably be done IRL. Putting likewise products next to each other, you know. Looks like we need more toilet paper. Oh, we got some space up here for shelving. Might be a little too crowded, though. Uh-oh. We gotta buy a lot more of that sushi. Wow, they're really buying a lot of that sushi. Look at that. That's crazy how much of that... is that the big sushi? That's the small one. That's crazy. $1,000 in sushi. May as well go all in. All right, they're buying crazy amounts of sushi. Yeah, I want to get my storage organized too. Yeah, you know, what'd be nice is the ability to maybe color code these things. But I think right now I'm putting more of my money into products because our shelves are really nice and full. We're making a lot of good money. Do some of this myself. Well, that's the $21 stuff. Wait, is this the bait? Okay, I want those in there. Okay. Is that the big? Where the hell? I might want the regular sushi. Wait, didn't I buy both? I bought both. Ah, here they are. I think. Yeah, there we go. That's the big O. Okay, there we go. Good idea to keep some of these boxes around. So then I think what we'll do is we'll put veal on the top and then salmon on the bottom next. And I bought so many steaks just so we don't have to buy them again. Like, we've got so many. I think we'll put some at the bottom. There we go. So we'll move that over. That's what I wanted to do. What the hell's this? Oh, hand soap. I'm going to keep one box. I think it's a good idea to maybe keep some boxes, right? So we can move some things around. It's like more water, more toilet paper, more veal. Always fun to see the tower collapse. Meat. That's right, we need more meat. I agree, chat. Yeah, I was trying to do some speed scanning while we were working on the register. Pro moves. Bum, 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 bum. There we go. Yep, yep, yep. Good, good, good. Okay, well, let's go ahead and open up. What are they doing? All right, let's open. Standing by. Hey. Bum 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 bum. Thank you for following there, Vince Wolf. Good to see you. I think you'll get Employee of the Month for sure. Dude, I'm the CEO of the year. Every year. That's me. Okay. It begins. Look at this. Here it comes. It begins. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Hey, how you doing? All right, $39, ma'am. Thank you. Hello, sir. A lot of bleach. Very suspicious. Oh, no change. Have a good day. Exact change. Yes. What am I going to sell? Burgers? I don't know, but I know there's new businesses coming to Big Ambitions that includes owning a cinema. We're going to be able to own a movie theater and stuff in that game. So that's cool. We'll have to buy licenses to movies and then like popcorn, soda, candy, that kind of thing. A blue Red Bull. Ahoy. Hello. 9810. Ooh. She's getting the quality susu sugar. That's a prop du dobre for sure. Wow. 130.05. Thank you, ma'am. Have a good day. Yeah, bleach and tea. He's having bleach tea. How lovely. Really brings out the flavor. Hi, Ren. Thank you very much for watching. Good to have you back. Thank you for watching. If you expanded storage and organized, it could have shelves full of... Oh, I don't care about optimization. We're just having fun. There's a lot of coulda, woulda, shouldas, but honestly, with this game being early access and whatnot, I don't think we have to get all sweaty about it. I think, really, what's nice about a game like this is just everybody's kind of just putting whatever, wherever, and I've been seeing people laying out shelves, like, diagonally, where they're facing this way. I've seen people, like, try to make their people go through a maze. Like, people will literally make it so that way there's, like, a maze at the door that people have to walk through. Like, they've tried to block the pathways and stuff. It's crazy. It's really cool to see everybody doing different stuff. Just having fun. Brambor, okay, thank you. 3655, have a good day. Thank you very much. $821. That's like at least $1. Yep. Hello, sir. More exact change. Look at this guy. Oh, finally check it out. Nope, going for them big chickens, though. No, actually, that was a frozen pizza. Oh, hi. Wasn't paying attention, ma'am. Sorry. 3905. Taximikit hedo. Ah! Someone made a Fry's Electronics in the game? Really? I don't know if we could do that yet without customization. Yeah, like an IKEA maze, exactly. Yeah, I've seen all sorts of shenanigans. People doing all sorts of whatever stuff. Boop, 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 boop. 11D50. Alright, let's get some more oil. Uh-oh, we're low on Brambor. Oil, Brambor. Oh, maybe some juice. Boop. Oil. Potato. Juice. And I'll do one more tally up in a minute. Chicken, bleach, and butter. That's going to be an interesting dinner, sir. Hi, ma'am. $87.90. Oh, there we go. Got it. Dude, they're buying the sushi like it's gone out of style. Crazy. Girl, who buys 5 packs of veal? You crazy. Hello, sir. Oh, okay. Maybe I'll buy more salmon. Salmon. Kofala. 465. Thank you, sir. Boop. Typing in the number makes a world of difference. I know, that's one of the new updates, too. We couldn't do that before. Everyone was like, dude, type it in with the number pad. I'm like, I can't. And now we can finally type it in with the number pad, which is... the best. Oh, customer waiting for checkout. You want me to open a nightclub? For sure. Club Goober. 9780. Ciao. Man, The potatoes in this game are huge. Like, it looks like there's four potatoes in there, but they're the size of a basketball. Bom, bom. Ooh, there's our Salmon. Customer! $21.60. That bleach alone would have been $20. Alright, 9 p.m. looks like everybody's bailing. Standing by. Yeah. Good greetings, yes. Good greetings indeed. Bro, okay. Hopefully in the future the AI is a little less dumb about, like, you know, three people being in one line. Like, that lady could go over to the other guy, and the guy in the back could come over. Like, sir, right over this way, please. Let me... Right here, sir. Like, nope. Not interested. Yeah, that's what I do. This is my perch. This is my my CEO perch, where I just look over all of the capitalism. Must own it all. There's rules against that. I will purchase the rules. I must own it all. Wow, sir, purchasing a lot of that Moussaka. What the hell is Moussaka? I need to look this up. Field trip. Let's take a field trip. Chat. Let's see. Ooh. Is this literally just... Oh my God. It's lasagna with lamb? Lamzagna? This channel is called My Little Kitchen, 83,000 subscribers. Oh my gosh, she's doing the layering! It's like a Greek lasagna. Oh my God. What is that on top? Is that mayonnaise? Now, what I'm about to do is, a lot of people don't do this. In fact, you shouldn't do this at all, but I'm just going to dump some mayonnaise on there and then some more mayonnaise. This is actually a solid mayonnaise. Oh, she's making a cake. Yeah, a cheesecake. God, that looks good. This is apparently the origin of lasagna. Oh, really? Oh, my God. That already looks so good. Oh yeah, the sauce is important for sure. I want to see her brown. Oh, is that the zucchini? Oh! The zook! Oh, it's so good. Oh, well. What the hell, are we in the Alps? Get out of here, Switzerland. All right. Back to the store. Switzerland, stop! This is Greece's moment to shine. You had your time. God. There's going to be an avalanche. If they don't stop, this whole place is going under. Oh, I can feel it. Uh-oh. Just kidding. It's not how this game works, chat. I tricked you. Oh, is that eggplant? Oh. Whatever, that looked delicious. Eggplant is very good. Purchase, consume, yeah, yeah. Endless profits. More is not enough. No sustainability. Oh, looks like we're full on the salmon now. I need to move those veal chops over. I swear, this has got to be the sound from one of the Sims where, like, you go skiing. Which, it's a weird reggae, Swiss reggae. It's like I'm on a tropical island in the Alps. Lol. Alright, enough. The song needs to be in my travel montage. Yeah, here's me sipping Mai Tais at the top of the Alps. But it has a little umbrella in it and the coconut, so, you know, it's tropical. Let's buy some shugs. Some coffee and pasta. Ah, yes, traditional Swiss music. Wait, actually, before I buy anything, let me let them stock the shelves, because we could have these items, they just haven't stocked them yet, maybe. And since I've hired employees, I refuse to work. They could do it for me. Damn, banger. Oh my god, I've detected a shortage of cakes. Sector 13, alert! Okay, crisis averted. Ma'am, dance with me. Come on. Come on, ma'am. Don't be that way. Let's dance. Come on. It's a celebration. I can see your eyeballs. Oh. Is this Mr. Bombastic? Mr. Bombastic. Cheese. Chocolate. What's on sale? Oh yeah, it's like Shaggy. Dude, we got into the banger section of the Sims music. You want a fast forward button after 9 for auto restocking? Yeah, that'd be fine, yeah, because, like, literally, if you've done everything there is to do, And you've hired employees to restock for you. You may as well have them do it. I mean, you paid them. I think for these products, we should do a whole show. Oh, then again, that's 32 veal we could put in there. You want quesadillas for dinner? Europeans just don't know the true power of a taco. They hate it. They hate flavor. You want me to put out an album? Now we're getting into tropical bangers. Now we need more rice, milk, soda. Man, look at this big business. We're making some big business. Ah, the Pog Lad's in the chat. Welcome back, lad. Good to see you. Oh, can I use this box to move the veal? No. Juice looks okay. Brambor is okay. Uh-oh. Fries, pizza, and chicken. Yep. It's fine. That was close. Yeah, the major food groups: fries, chicken, and of course, pizza. Hand soap. Bum, bum. Okay, maybe I'll buy some veal so I can scoot those. Yeah. Wait, that means I need to buy more sushi, right? Sir. Sir? Veal equals venison of the sea. Yes. Chat. I guess I need to buy more chicken. Unless, does that guy have chicken? Is that chicken, sir? It is. Is that the kid from Wild Thornberries? Me? Is this the Sims Vacation soundtrack? Yeah, I put on 8 hours of Sims music. And some of these songs are absolute bangers. This is good. I could listen to this on a road trip. All right, let's buy some sugar. Funny every time. Yeah, I'll play this during the title DLC for Gas Station Simulator tonight for sure. Mm-hmm. Blah, 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 blah. Blah, 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 blah. How do you know it's good music? Blah, 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 blah. Hey, Macarena. Hey, Macarena. All right, are these the big or the small? That's the small. Damn it, sir. No, damn it, sir. Okay, I want to put only the big ones in that aisle. Yeah, I wish they had a little, like a little... At this point, we just need a wheelbarrow. Oh, that's the small. There, okay, now. God damn it, sir! God damn it, no! Alright, whatever. Whatever, I'm opening up the store. Let's roll! Damn it. Switzerland, stop! What the hell is the combo of Switzerland and reggae? Okay. Why is this a combo? Who thought these two would go together? Hey, let's put in Caribbean steel drum music, but then toss in a yodeler. Like, all right, yeah, all right. People go skiing on vacation, fair enough. And yeah, people go to the Caribbean and, like, windsurf and whatever else. But not both. There's, like, two different... Unless you're a Swiss person going on vacation in the Caribbean. Or vice versa. That salt looks like cans of Red Bull. You're right, chat. It's a Jamaican bobsled team. That's right. Steel drums and yodeling are a trend ahead of its time. You think we're listening to music that they're going to be listening to in 2030? That's what the kids are going to think is both hip and cool. Olive oil's too expensive for me? Ma'am. There we go again, the Swiss interrupting. Switzerland is literally attacking the stream. I went to Switzerland. I thought they were nice, but apparently it was a trap. Non-dairy olive oil. Yeah, we need some new bear emotes. You guys love those bear emotes. I got to do like a tier 2. Like what we should do is this. We keep all the emotes that we have, but we make them better. Like Space Bear. But, like, imagine Space Bear 2.0. Like, we make him 8K graphics, you know? $1, Bob. Oh, God, here we go. Another Swiss banger. God, wow. Ma'am, I saw you put that, oh my god. Whoa, you having an office party? Jeez. $18.10. Uh-oh, that's a glitch. Yeah, we're listening to traditional Polish music. Which they played a lot in the restaurants, and I thought it was nice. Poland's cool. Last time you were in Switzerland was August of 1993 in Airola. Dude, you gotta go back to the future. Poland is my heritage, yeah, and German. Part goober, too. Bro, you came here to buy two things of candy with $100? God, all right. Breaks $100 to buy two things of like cotton candy. Brambor shortage. Wait. What's behind the door near the register? That just leads to the storage room, but I can't access that yet until I've made the store a little bigger. Scallop gratin, potato.
So no man.
Yeah, nobody wants that scallop gratin. Damn, big spender, bro. 75 cents for you. I feel like it's super dark over here. We gotta get some more lights. Oh, that's fine. Whatever. Damn it, Switzerland. The only thing the Swiss drums are missing is more cowbell. Wow. Switzerland sends its best regards. Yeah. Hey, Switzerland was cool. I got more trains to explore, dude. You guys have been asking if I'm going to, like, do more train sim DLC, and it's like, yeah, hell yeah. And what I want to do now is, like, drive on more virtual lines around the world and then actually go on them. That'd be amazing. Go actually ride like a beautiful little train line. Beautiful. Alright, let's let the stalkers do their thing. All right, should we upgrade our storage? I don't know. We need to upgrade the lights too. What did we need? $6,500 to upgrade the store? We need like $6,000 to upgrade the size of the store. Okay, let's fix these lights because everybody hates this, right? Are we in agreement that we all hate this? Do we all hate the lights? I can adjust them, I think. Okay, you know what we're gonna do? Oh boy. I'm gonna box up all the lights. Oh, this song's nice. This song's about ceiling lights. It's an old Swiss song about the troubles of properly lighting a commercial office space. You can hear, you can tell by all the yodeling. Why the hell does this guy sound like Hootie and the Blowfish all of a sudden? You guys hear this? I'm getting some heavy, like, Hootie and the Blowfish vibes here. I This game needs a damn grid system for the lights. It really does. Darius Rucker. Oh my god, that light's not centered. Oh, this is going to be painful, chat. We're going to spend the next hour. I might have to do a super mega extendo stream. I'm going to need everybody to pull an extra shift in the chat. Chat, I'm going to need you to come in and stay late to the chat. Because it's lighting night. And I'm going to need some of you guys to dig deep and... Look, go buy a Red Bull. No sleeping. It's going to be a tough night. But we're all going to have to... You know, we're going to have to sacrifice a little bit to make it... To make magic happen. You're going to need OT pay? All right. I will pay chat in one Bob Ross emote and two party boats. Or a pizza party. There's got to be an easier way to do this. I think we're just going to have to square it up with the windows. Like, there's no way I can do this without... God, I hate it. Okay. Now I just want to go play Hobo Tough Life again and hear you preach. You preach. Wait, is this copyright? This would be copyright. That part I think is copyright. I gotta skip that. That's like an old copyrighted song for sure. There we go. Oh, this is from Sims Superstar. You love Hobo Tough Life? Yeah. Wait, can I look at the floor and it'll place on the ceiling or no? No, okay. God, these lights. Ugh, chat. This is gonna be bad. OCD is like, chat, what's the best way we could get these lights to like line up? I don't really know. I need a tool to do it, because like there's no way I can do it free placement. Maybe we could just do it for our store, like where we put it in the aisles. Like, okay, let's do this. Let's at least put one, like two by the door, right? Let's put one here. Or maybe we'll put three by the door, like one on over the door. Okay, this is gonna suck. You have la fan. This sucks. Now there's only one set of lights in the game. I should have just left it alone. I really should have. I think the best we can do is just try. If we try, that's all we can That's the best we can do. Welcome to the amazing world of commercial lighting. I'm your host, Raptor, and welcome. Today's episode, what not to do in a commercial office setting or retail space. It's actually looking somewhat decent. Never mind. You could do it. Just do your best. Do my best. It's looking better, I think. It's not going to be perfect because we don't have a grid system or any sort of way to measure. Dude, how did the ancient Egyptians install their lighting? Egyptian electricians must have been really good. Because they didn't have, like, computers, dude. They had to lay all their electrics, like, by hand, dude. They didn't have computers. God damn it, I couldn't continue the joke without laughing. Damn it. My favorite thing though is like being serious like that in the chat and wait for one guy to crack. Like the whole thing with the walking in Star Citizen or the other thing where I'd be like, it's like, yeah, veal is deer and venison is baby cow. And there'd always be that one guy. That is incorrect. It'd be like, there'd always be a guy in the chat who would like jump up like Phoenix Wright. Objection! You don't know what I'm talking about. Here, we got to do this. Let's see if we can do this. It'd be like this.
Objection!
Sometimes people in chat can't handle it. Sometimes there's a little emotional breakdown from some people who watch. They're not in on the joke. Sometimes that happens. The best part for that in the YouTube comments, though, is when you'll get the timestamp. College thesis breakdown. There'll be the timestamp and then seven paragraphs as to why you're wrong. I was like, dude, it was just a joke. Like, I know, but you were wrong. Okay. Translation. Oh, it was a joke? Uh-oh. I look like a fool. I better double down now. Your joke is incorrect. Oh my god, that is a great shirt idea. your joke is incorrect, sir. Oh my god. Like, I feel like these are the same people who would kidnap the magician from that Fox series, like in the late 90s, early 2000s, where like the camera will not cut away. And these would be the same people to like ambush him and be like, you need to tell us what you did. It's like, well, part of the fun is not knowing and guessing. Okay, my lights are actually like better. I shouldn't even be. This is actually not that bad. I'm going to do the lighting like that because that's where the cash registers are going to be. And then maybe we could do some custom lighting where the aisles will be, because the aisles will be probably not changing too much, I think, right? But I do need lights at the front of the stores. How do I want to do this? Ooh, this is looking good. This is actually looking decent. I'm happy with this. I'm happy. I mean, it's better than it was before. It was like a constellation before. That's what Tan said. Genius. It was a genius assessment of the store. Now just imagine if we sold fuel. We were a convenience store. That'd be very convenient. Okay. I feel like this aisle's like pretty well lit, but this is kind of dark back here. But when we buy an expansion to the store, it's going to be over there, so we'll be fine. I'll put this light over the door. Okay, cool. All right, all done. Lighting done. Boring part over. It's all good. We're fine. Okay. Oh, that's nice. That's not bad. That's not bad. If we could get bigger lights, it would just be easier to do the lighting. Like, if they replace those with just, like, longer fluorescent lights, then you could just put, like, one here, one there. I know it's not perfect, but it's way better than it was. It truly is. Like, before, I just wanted to always look at the floor so chat couldn't see how embarrassed I was of the lighting. But now it's good. Okay, so what are we doing? We need more milk, more cereal, tea, coffee, pasta. Let me save quick to fix that little issue. There we go. Teehee. Yeah, we're going to get a tan in the store, exactly. It's like looking into the sun. Oh, chat. Oh, yes. Bum, bum, bum. We should change the prices. We're only making 200 profit. I don't know what we're going to do to make more profit. But also, I guess it didn't help because I did buy like a ton of veal yesterday, so I did spend about like $500 worth of money to stock all these shelves. Oh, toilet paper. Eggs. Yogurt. Milk. All right, let's go with that. I don't know. Looking good. I usually cut my pasta after it's cooked with a pair of scissors. No, you don't. No, you don't. That's a crime. Ooh. Wow, the store actually feels a lot brighter now. This is nice. Bum, 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 bum. Okay. So now we gotta wait for all of our store people to stock the shelves. Mm-hmm. Cleaner and tablets, too. How are we doing on bleach? Oh, yeah, we should buy some of that, too. And then... Chicken? Chicken. Two things of chicken and shampoo. And then we'll do a price check. Chat seems to be quite keen on raising the prices. Chat wants higher profits at all times. All right. All right, chat, here's what we're going to do. We're going to stock these shelves, and then I'm going to raise everything. I think we can get away with 30 cents. So if people will buy something for a dollar, we can charge $1.30. Or 1 krona. Or crown. Or zloty. Or a Swiss peso. Swiss peso. That's going to be my rapper name. I mean, you have Post Malone. It's your boy, Swiss peso. Did I get the door yet? No, I got to expand the storeroom a little bit. We could do that. That could be our next thing. If chat wants. Chat's like the shareholders of Member Mart. We're having our annual shareholders meeting. In the first quarter, All right, let's go through all of our products. This will be fun. Okay, so... we basically just have to do the math and increase it, right? I don't know if I want to go that high, though. Maybe we'll do 20 cents more. Maybe we'll just do 20 cents more. Yeah. I think so. Oh, wait. Let's do 620. What? Sad face? More? What do you mean more? There's a threshold. I think it's 30 cents. That's 25 cents. Oh, we have Moussaka there and there. Okay. I still got to get rid of this frickin' orange juice. But it'd be easier to organize things if I could have some extra boxes, you know? 0.4. You want to go 40 cents more? Bro. You need to... Look, I'm raising the prices specifically for you. Person in the chat asking me to raise prices. You know your name. Wait, is that 54? Okay, we'll do 70. We need more toilet paper. Let's see, yeah, that's fine. Yeah, everything must go. Chat wants prices to be $0 or $1 million. These are the business suggestions I'm getting, either $2 million or zero. We're going to get all these. Oh, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to get all these complaints now. People are going to come in here and be like, I hate paying less for more. That's what's going to happen. Wow, $3 for a soda? I thought this was America. Akia! They still buy, don't worry. Wait a minute, are you like a are you in the professional leagues for Supermarket Simulator? Are you like a final boss? Whoa. Was that everything? In the future, they're going to make it so you can set all the prices from the computer, too, because it is a little bit of a pain in the butt to go around to every product and do it by hand. Middle management's not happy with my numbers. What, you guys? Elden Ring Simulator. Simulator. All right, you're getting pulled over. I'm opening the store. Yeah, to do it one at a time is kind of tedious, but they will make it so it's the computer. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Am I going to play Dragon's Dogma 2? You know, probably not, because there's a lot of games that I want to play would take a lot of time to get through to roll credits, and this year I don't know if I have time with all the things that I'm working on to like continuously go through them. Like, I wanted to play Final Fantasy Rebirth and some other stuff like that, but I think time will prohibit me from doing some of those things. I know they're good, though. I would like to play them. But I think it's not good for me or for you guys watching to start something and then not finish it, especially if it's a story game. Like a game like this, we could stop anytime because it's an early access redundancy simulator, basically. A repetitive redundancy simulator, but that's fun. But then the good thing is we could stop whenever we want. It's like me playing coin pushers or fruit slots. I could stop anytime I wanted. Chad didn't believe me, but I was able to do it. $55.90. Can we install a card skimmer for extra revenue? If you want. Tree Fitty? This person needs Tree Fitty. There you go. $30.30. Oh, that's not it. There we go. Hi, ma'am. Welcome to the store. Can I help you with anything? Great. Have a good day. Hello? Oh, God. Oh, this sounds like a mischievous RPG character from, like, Final Fantasy VI. This is a character in your party named Goobermon. The Goobermon? You can't do that. Ah, it is I, Goobermon. Alex is our Goobermon in our community. Hey, Alex, you can't use the grenade launcher up against the wall. You'll kill the entire squad. Great, now we're all dead. Thanks, Goobermon. Goobermon, the newest Pokemon, yeah. Do you think we're going to reach 4K at end of day? Really? All right, we'll try. Well, let me check and make sure we don't run out of any products. Uh-oh. Toilet paper alert. Toilet paper, milk, cakes, cereal. We need juice, too. Dude, the stalkers are going crazy all day. They're just stalking nonstop. I love this song. We'll see if chat was right about raising prices to make more money. That doesn't make sense to me. A corporation wouldn't do that. You're telling me raising the price, shrinking the size of the bottle or the box, and then saying 30% more on the label, and then utilizing our profits to make it so that the federal government can't sue us by suing them first, that's the way to run a business? Doesn't make sense. I thought it was through honesty, integrity, not manipulation and lies. Doesn't make sense. No corporation would do that. I still think it's, like, even with these lights, it's still dark in the back room. I like these shenanigans music. Chat's calling me a sweet summer child. I want to kind of be more of like a sweet and sour, like, autumn toddler. No, young adult. Now, this music sounds like the beginning of a Bo Burnham song. Do I make the employees pay for their uniforms? I make them pay for everything, including their own pay. Okay, 5190. Next. Hi, how are you today, ma'am? Welcome to the supermarket. Okay, exact change. Thank you. Have a great day. I love you. Okay. Game needs lighting outside, too. Like where there needs to be lights on the buildings shining down. You know what I mean?
You know what I mean?
Okay, I need to order some more lights for here, actually. I don't know. Wow, we made over 4,000. I was right, chat. Raising the prices did work. I'm glad I was here. End of day. Look, 10 products too expensive. Chat, we were getting 400 store points before, now only 300. Your corporate greed has cost us a point. I think they want more of that big box sushi. Uh-oh. There we go. And cries on the way to the bank. How many more upgrades till the inside door is operational? Two, maybe? Let me buy some products and we'll figure it out. Cheese, butter, and those snack cakes. Level 3 of the storage room? Right, I think we're at level 2. Alright, well, let's make it more efficient then. And we'll buy a new shelving unit soon. There we go. Okay. Is there a way to bottle and profit from employees' tears? Wow, I have no idea. Melody's been your ringtone on your phone for a long time? Interesting. Oh, you're right. Lottery ticket sales and phone minute cards. Oh, my God. Scam. All right, let's grow the storage room to level triple. Yay, we did it. Now we don't have to go outside anymore. We're a true gamer. We can stay inside at all times. Look at that. Uh-oh. Eh, whatever. Damn, this music is a damn final boss battle on the accordion. Yeah, boxes in storage will stack, yeah. I'll just put this here. Okay, I think I can buy. You know what? Hold on. Let's, all right, I'm going to put this in here for a minute. Thinking. Wait a minute. Yes, excellent, good. Maximize all the space, yes, good. There we go. Good, good. Good. Okay, so now we could buy at least, what, three more, maybe? I gotta put the desk somewhere. That's a good spot. No. There we go. Perfect. Yeah, there's a circus of capitalism going on right now. Do 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 do. Circus of value. I don't think I can fit a third one there, so we'll just do this. The hell? Okay. Damn the fire marshal. We can do what we want for money. I think I accidentally bought one too many. Ah, that's right. I can throw this in a box. And we'll pretend that never happened. Cool. Boom, boom, boom. Money, yes. Good money. Let's put this way. There we go. Cool. Okay, so now we got a lot more shelf space and a lot more shelves in here. So what do we got for shelves? What is it? Three... 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Am I going to play Alone in the Dark? Well, our schedule's down below in the description, or exclamation point schedule. I did see that it came out today, and it looked pretty cool. I don't know if I'll have time to play it and beat it between now and when I leave for Boston. And I really want to start doing... I want to start making sure I don't start games that I don't finish. There were a few last year that I really wanted to finish and I didn't get a chance to do so. So I want to finish games like Last Train Home and Banished Ghost New Eden before we even like start Red Dead Redemption and stuff like that too. I could easily just do, you know, something that really works on YouTube is just doing one and done. So like you just play the, you play part one of a game and then never come back to it. And that's good for you know, channel growth and from new people checking out the channel, but that's not why I play games, and I think many of you watch the channel not to see... I mean, for a game like this to do, like, a first look or whatever like this, that's fine, but for a game where there's, like, credits to roll, I want to do that. Okay, shall we open our store? I think we should get started. What do we got? What else should we buy? Candy? Chat, what do we need? What are the products that we should buy and order? Anything else that we should probably get stacked up? Maybe toilet paper, bleach, oil? Toilet paper, bleach, oil, maybe chicken? All right, toilet paper. Bleach. Something like that. Wow. Fowls Geek gifting 10 tier 2 subs to everybody in the Twitch chat. Damn. Exclamation point Twitch if you're on YouTube and haven't yet followed over on Twitch. Thank you very much for the gifted memberships. It's my birthday on Saturday too, by the way. So thanks to all you guys for all the memberships, super chats, gift bombs, subscriptions. Thank you very much for being so kind. I really appreciate that. Thank you. That's so nice of you. Let's see. Oh, let's do some candy. Some candy, y'all. Yeah, thank you again, Fowls Geek, for the support. Community loves it. We need hand soap. Let's see. Yep, got to hand it to you, chat. You did a good job on that one. Eventually, there will be stalkers who will then pick up stuff from the wherever you drop it off to put it into the storage. My coffee and tea, I think we should get too. And rice, maybe? Okay. Well, what a mess. I'm going to put whatever wherever, and then eventually we'll start organizing. Guys are working fast. Oh, the label's up there. Okay. Candy. Bum, 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 bum. By the way, I'm CapCap23 on YouTube. I only do gift subs on Twitch. Sorry. Happy birthday. Oh, don't say sorry. Thank you very much for the support. I appreciate your gift bomb. Thank you. Very nice of you. Wait, you can't tip on YouTube? Well, there is a link down below in the description. You can go through PayPal link if you'd like to. You can also drop a super chat or a super sticker on YouTube. You can also do something called a super thanks, where you drop like a... It's like a super chat, but in the comments section after a video's gone live or like a live stream is over. You can also drop gift memberships, or you can become a member yourself by hitting the join button, or exclamation point merch, or use code Raptory at checkout. There's many ways you can support the channel without doing anything crazy if you'd like. Our store's looking nice. More eggs, yogurt. And maybe flour? I don't know what we have in storage anymore. I see we have tea. There's some flour there. I hope they can reach those. I hope they should. Does that go to you? YouTube will take their 30% cut, and the federal government will take 30%. Then if you spend that money, another 30% disappears via taxes. So, but that's how it goes no matter where you go. So, it's the thought that counts. It really is. If somebody comes in and it's just like a dollar, it's like, wow, thank you very much. Like I really can't express how thankful I am for people just watching the channel, let alone becoming like a member or something like that. Like our lovely Sigma Apex tier 36-month member, the Silverback Gorilla. That guy. You think we need more salmon? Okay. Well, we got 27 remaining. But we can put it on the list. You want to give me something for the birthday? Yeah, if you want to send me stuff, !! P.O. Box, send me anything at any time. A postcard, something nice from where you live, whatever, like some chocolates. You know, it's all good. It's all appreciated. If you want to. Boom, boom, boom. All right, and now the business begins. Initiate business. Could I claim the travel money and the new hardware as expenses? Well, I'll leave that to my accountant. Do I do unboxings? I'll unbox stuff like, for example, the when Pacific Drive sent over a really cool toolbox and stuff, I kind of did that live. I'll share unboxings and stuff with all of you. Oh my god. I think today is Uthris's birthday. I think Uthris has a birthday today. Hello, sir. Welcome to the store. Doing the number pad is so nice. Yeah, we got a lot of customers. Claim all sunglasses as a business expense? Yeah. Talk about chocolate. Which one is best, Swiss chocolate or Belgian chocolate? I'll be honest. I don't really remember if I had much Belgian chocolate. I had waffles. I think I maybe had chocolate, but I got a little box of chocolates. It was really pretty with like a brown, it was a brown box with like an orange ribbon on it. And ate a bunch of those, and those were probably... That was like the perfect chocolate, like perfect size, great flavor. It was wonderful. A little treat. $10.50 for that much chocolate? We're gonna break 4K again. Bum bum bum. Judge what people are buying. I know. Yeah, Swiss chocolate's good. Mm-hmm. Belgian beer? Yeah, that was good too. I enjoyed everything that I had. Everything was good, great, or outstanding. Mm-hmm. Hi, ma'am. Welcome to Lay Store. What's your strat on saving money and keeping the stock up? I don't even know. Things just kind of happen, I think. Yeah, now that we got 4K and now that we've got a big old storeroom, what we could do is buy some more lights too, but what we can do is start, whenever products are on sale at the start of a day, we could just start stocking up on whatever's cheap. So if milk goes on sale, we'll just buy like... Just buy like 10 cartons of milk. Boxes. Did raising prices help? Yeah. I think I'm going to start charging $10 million for a thimble of milk. And then have the customer do self-checkout, and then we pass the savings down to them. And by savings, I mean... I don't know. It seems like a good buzzword. Refer to spending money as saving. Come on in and get two Ferraris. Two for one on Ferraris. Save $10 billion. No. You spent. Now, we might be able to expand the store soon. We need $6,000 for that, though. Wait, 75. Oh, uh-oh. Cleaner. Oh, shit. Okay. Well, it's the end of the day. Too late. Bum, 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 bum. You know what's cool, chat? After this stream, we get to go to run another store in Gas Station Simulator's new DLC known as Tidal Wave. If you're enjoying this game, don't miss our stream tonight because we will be pumping fuel for boats, pumping fuel for cars, defending against sharks, defending against tidal waves, trying not to piss off a volcano, stocking shelves for snacks and drinks and ice cream, repairing cars, doing a car wash, and also cleaning and decorating our gas station. The biggest problem, though, is I think there might be a glitch with it where we also have some showers for people who go snorkeling and windsurfing to, like, hit the showers before they... go or come back or whatever. But I don't think I can clean it. I haven't been able to clean the damn showers, so I don't know what the problem is. Yeah, the Party Boat song. If anybody can find the Tidal Wave DLC Party Boat song, not the Party Bus, not the classic one. I wonder if we still have that one. I think we do, but... Oh, this is all the Sims music. This has been a great soundtrack. This is chill. But yeah, we're going to be doing more of that. Am I going to play more Sons of the Forest? Maybe. Exclamation point schedule or link down below in the description for what we're going to do in the future. I'd like to, but I first got to go do this thing for PAX. But there could be some time for more of that with Red. Sons of the Forest was quite fun. Building the house is a good time. Okay, we need tablets, cleaner, chicken, oil. And we'll order that for tomorrow. Yo, Chris, thanks for the 34 months as a Raptor Plus. Say more chicken, bruh. Hell yeah. Yeah, we'll play Prison Architect too. That's why I covered it in a video on the channel. I'm looking forward to that one too. You are too, it seems. Chat's excited to see me play more games, I think. Oh yeah, we need more Brambor. More Brambor. We'll let the boys work for a little bit. Potatoes. How did that stream go? My phone died during a 9. Oh, it was great. The gas station DLC is wonderful. It almost feels like playing... It's almost as if they made a sequel. Like, it's literally a whole new gas station. It's the regular game, but the gas station's completely different, and they've added some new stuff to do, like snorkeling and wakeboard rentals and other things like that. So, it's... I think they could have almost gotten away with calling it Gas Station Simulator 2. I wouldn't have been surprised, but they didn't need to do that, and the way they did it was good. 7 Days to Die is showing off their new alpha and console support at the conferences too. Ooh. Wow, we got $5,000 now. Hey, total profit $500. Awesome. Even though we spent $1,800 on upgrades buying that new section and new shelves, and we bought 1,300 supply, and yet we're still profitable. Damn, we are powerful. Nothing can stop us. Good. Okay, we need lights in here too, and potatoes, but we'll buy that order now. Make sure we save that. Yeah, we'll buy now hummus and wow extra large falafel meal for two. Something like this. That's right. 2 days gonna be the day where they throw it back to you. Tell me more. Lol. Alright guys, that's gonna be it for our live stream of Supermarket Simulator for today, but we'll be back tomorrow and on Friday before I leave for Boston with more of this one. So we'll be playing this pretty much every day we can. It's a very fun game. Probably one of the best on Steam right now for anybody to play. This is a good... Yeah, if you get bored of playing some Stardew update and want something, to cleanse the palate, this is a damn good one. So, yeah, I know, we're out of time. We actually went over time. So thank you again for all the super chats. Thank you for all the memberships. Thank you for all the member milestones. Thanks for all the birthday wishes. Thanks for tuning in to this channel every day, no matter what we play. It's always a pleasure to see you and have you all here. So I'll see you all in a bit for Gas Station Simulator Tidal Wave DLC coming up next on the channel. Thanks again for watching, everybody.